This is a simple workflow for Wan 2.2 models, and these two are the high and low noise quantize models. These are the power LoRa node and then the Sage Attention patch followed by the accelerator, LightX2V. All goes to their respective K-sampler to generate the video below. The result generated by this simple workflow looks great, and the best part is, you can also generate images using the same setup. The video you just saw has 81 frames, but for a single image, we only need one frame. So I had simply changed the number of frames from 81 to 1. And in this section, I will use the Save Image node. The video nodes will not work with one frame. It's better to disable them. The generation took 60 seconds, and I got the image. For some reason, this looks like a cartoon, but I got the image based on the prompt. Now that we've generated an image, let's take it a step further. We'll improve it and experiment with different styles using LoRa. Apply a filter on Civet AI for LoRa. The older Wan 2.1 LoRa should work, but I will keep it short and download LoRa based on the model I am using. I found this sci-fi movie LoRa, and both the high and low noise files are present here. And this is the second LoRa I found. In the workflow, I will bypass these LoRa nodes and use the Power LoRa node. These are the latest Lightning LoRa released a few days ago. The generation time was around 40 seconds, but the image was not clear. The older 480p distilled LoRa, which was for the Wan 2.1 model, gave a better result. The 480p distilled LoRa, combined with the sci-fi LoRa, produced a slightly better result. The image size is around 700 pixels, but I suggest generating a full HD or a 1536 pixel image for better results. The image has the old school film effect from the LoRa, but the quality can be improved. I tried the other LoRa which I had from Civet AI, and this is the result. The LoRa definitely works for images as we can see here. Now what remains is the quality of the image. The text-to-video workflow can generate images, but there is a better workflow which is focused towards image generation. These disabled nodes are for systems with 24 GB or more graphic memory. And then the high and low noise GGUF models followed by the LoRa node. I forgot to add the Power LoRa node here. We'll be adding now. The workflow is similar as you can see. These are for Sage Attention, and then the prompt notes. And then it goes to both the K-samplers. This can be turned on to add sharpness and film grain to the image. For beginners, there are two custom nodes in this workflow that you might have a hard time finding. The sampler and scheduler used here is from a custom node. Copy this word, RES4LYF, and search in the manager. This sampler makes the generation slow, but the result produced is worth waiting. The second node collection could be the VR game, DevGirl. The link will be shared in the description. Copy the project link. Go to the custom node folder, type the clone command, and clone the project using the link. I will be using the Power LoRa node for accelerator, and this Instagram Girl LoRa, which was released a few days ago. My prompt was about a woman, and the image generated from this workflow was better than what we saw earlier. This image has better details. The skin looks better, definitely better than Flux models. The image resolution I suggested in this workflow can be too much for a smaller graphic card. But smaller size will affect the quality. Try keeping it close to a 1080p resolution. Generating a 1080p image will consume more VRAM, so you have to find the closest resolution you can get. On my 4060 Ti 16GB, the first generation took 280 seconds, and later it was around 175 seconds. This old man is wearing a watch that looks from the future. Also, these glasses look modern. In my previous video, I mentioned that the high noise model is responsible for generating motion. After a few steps, the low noise model takes over, adding details to the video frames. However, if you let the low noise model do all the work, you'll end up with an image that's overloaded with detail. I should have decreased the generation steps, but you got the idea. The sharpness and grain level needs to be adjusted for this workflow, which is doable. The workflows will be shared in the video's description. The models I used in this video were the text-to-video GGUF models. For clip models, you can use either GGUF or the FP8 scale version. I have used the GGUF to keep things lighter. The VAE used will be the same as we have used in the older Wan 2.1 workflows. Links to these files will be in the description. I hope this was informative and useful to someone.